the initial project, which was just a year's worth of data, really kind of blew my mind to bowhead whales, and it sort of opened up this underwater world to us, and it led to a lot of questions. So if we make the assumption it's a reproductive display and it's just males, does each male have his own song? Does he keep it among years? Do they change songs? And honestly, we still don't have answers to that. But one of the reasons we kept putting this hydrophone out was to see if we would hear the same song between years. And if we did, maybe then we could assume that each male or a cohort of males had their song. And that then could, with a little bit of arm waving, let us get maybe a minimum population estimate for this incredibly endangered species. But that's turned out to not be the case at all, because we've never heard the same song twice. And because it is still a pretty small population, we would expect to hear the same song in multiple years if the animals are consistently coming back to that area. And to date, we haven't. That doesn't mean with future data we won't, but for now we haven't. So I like to use the analogy of classical music versus jazz. So the people who don't necessarily listen to whale song for a living, and there's not that many of us, can easily grasp what I mean between the differences in the songs. So humpback whale songs are very long, they're elaborate, they're formed from notes that make up phrases, the phrases are combined into themes, and those themes are repeated in a very structured order to make a song. With bowhead whales, boy, the number of notes, if we want to use that terminology, right now it seems to be in the hundreds and thousands, and they creak and they rattle and they wail and they sound like sirens, or they sound like fingernails on a chalkboard sometimes. And the way they combine these many different notes into songs reminds me much more of somebody like John Coltrane or Miles Davis than it does Bach. So it's a good way, I think, for people in their mind to think, okay, I understand what classical music is, what it sounds like, and then there's jazz. You know, the Arctic is one of those places that is ice-covered, it's cold, it's dark. Most people are never going to go to the Arctic. But when you put a hydrophone, an underwater microphone, through the ice and listen, it's like this whole other world exists down there. And bowheads are part of the sonic environment. And the bowhead itself is a superlative animal. They can live 200 years. 200 years! They've got the thickest blubber, the longest baleen, and they can break through ice a foot and a half thick. So these are amazing Arctic animals. And most people probably don't know they exist. And they just make our planet an even more special place to me.